This is incredible. There's no Russian soldiers here. We were here the other night. There were Cossacks, the local self-defense forces, Russian military truck, Russian special forces, just outside of this base here, and now they're all gone. We're at the Crimean Parliament, and the big news is that the deputies here decided that they want to join Russia today. They've also decided to move a referendum on the issue forward to March 16th.
Сегодня сессия приняла решение большинством голосов, 80%, приняла ли решение о том, что Крым исторический момент у нас переломный. Один вопрос о том, что Крым на референдум выходит с одним вопросом о вступлении в Российскую Федерацию.
What they said after that was that any force other than the Russian force here are going to be considered to be illegal insurgents, which means that the Russians might be stepping their operations up against the Ukrainians in the next few days. But now the ball is in the Kremlin's court, and it's up for Putin to decide what to do next. We've noticed there have been reports, and we've seen ourselves, that the Russians have pulled back from a number of military bases that they have been holding under siege for the last few days. And we're thinking that that might have something to do with the fact that the OSCE are trying to get through.
Как вы думаете, почему отсюда ушли российские военные, казаки, которые тут стояли на протяжении нескольких дней?
Ну, у нас только есть предположение. В принципе, я думаю, они общеизвестны. Это было связано с приездом миссии ОБСЕ наблюдателей. Ну, по имеющейся вот информации, которая недавно поступила, наблюдателей ОБСЕ на территории Крыма не пустили.
То есть можно предположить, что они скоро вернутся?
Да. Ну, такое предположение было. После того, как отработают наблюдатели, они вернутся.
Another thing we found out about earlier today was that apparently the Russians had scuttled a ship in one of the bays in Crimea. So we sent our cameraman, Freddie Paxton, down there to check it out. And what he saw was that they'd actually towed a decommissioned ship, dumped it in the middle of the bay, and they towed it to the bay to prevent any ships from leaving it or entering it. The reason they want to stop ships from leaving is because there are some Ukrainian warships in there. And the reason they may want to stop ships from entering is because there's an American battleship on its way to the Black Sea through the Bosphorus right now.
Ну, вчера была подготовлена как бы спецоперация российским Черноморским флотом. Прибыли сюда 7 кораблей, 7 суден. И был списанный корабль Очаков, который был поставлен на бочке посреди входа в озеро Дунузлав и затопленный с целью не дать прохода и выхода в бухту Дунузлав в озеро украинских кораблей.
So there are a lot of theories out there, but the Russians have definitely stepped up what they're doing, because it's pretty serious if they take a decommissioned warship, blow a giant hole in it and dump it in the middle of the water.
Ура! 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 Ура!
Now that Crimea has declared that it wants to be a part of Russia, the big question is what Putin is going to do next, because he could easily have the Russian parliament produce legislation making it possible to absorb this region of Ukraine, but he also could come out and be the international arbiter that he wants the world to see him as and say that Crimea is still a part of Ukraine, but if it wants to keep the region, then it has to play by his rules. Thank you.